Coming to the next, that is, we have already done the divide a line segment in a ratio 3:2. We have done already, but we have one more method of solving this. Okay, that is not only one method what we have done. One more method we have. That what is that method? We will go through it. The ratio will be remains 3:2 only. So now, what is the method is? The method is. So I will not tell you to go with this method only, because while constructing the triangle, this method will not useful. Only the construction of what. Line segment, it is a construction of what? A line segment, the ratio of the line segment we have, in that only it is possible. The alternate method what we have, that is possible in this only. We will not have the useful, this will method will not be useful in a construction of a similar triangle. So just you will have to learn. Okay, just you go through it. So similarly, you can draw one line. So that time I have taken 10 centimeter. So now also I will take a 10 centimeter line only. Same, starting will be same, same construction of the same line. So that name you can give as the A to B. So take it as A to B. But it is only for the line segment. Huh? Again, I am saying that. So now we have to draw the acute angle. What we have done the previous is similar thing we have to do. So here you have to draw the acute angle. Not only this side now, this one you can take as the A to X. Similarly, we have to draw the acute angle at B also, okay, acute angle at the B also, but we can't take directly as a B. So what we have to do, what is the angle we have taken here, that is A to X, what angle we have taken, same angle we have to take at the B. So for that purpose, take a compass, okay, the method, take a compass, keep on A as a center, and here the first thing we have to use is one, we have to draw one line, one arc we have to draw, one arc we have to draw. Similar length we have to take and keep on B now and draw one more arc on the top. Okay. So what arc you have drawn here? Same arc you have to draw it here. Same length. Now very importantly, this measurement. So this point to this measurement, how much difference we have, that we have to take. I have told you not to use the protractor. So therefore we have to use this method to draw the parallel lines. This is the parallel line draw. So same measurement you have to take, how much difference we have. Similarly, you have to keep on this point where the touch it is touching, and we have to draw one line over here. So exactly you draw. So this is the line, this is the point what you have. So now take a pencil, keep on B as a center and draw this line. This point and this line we have to join and we have to draw. And while joining, one thing I will clarify you. This line what you will draw now, that must be parallel to this line. If it is not parallel, you are going to get the wrong answer. So I will not suggest this method to go, because it is little bit confusion at the starting. Later on it will be easier. Later on it will be easier. Now next one, very importantly, I will little bit zoom it. Now very importantly, you see at this one point what you have the 3:3, we have to take from the A downward. What is the 2:2 what we have, that we have to take from B onwards. So you have to take a compass, you take down any measurement, how much measurement you want you can take, okay, it is left to you, no problem, how much measurement you have want take down, but don't change this measurement once again, only once you have to take it, and don't change it now till the end. So keep on A as a center, keep on A as a center, draw one line. See, here little bit confusion you may have. So here draw one line. Similarly, keep on this point and draw one more line. And keep on here and draw one more line. Now no need to draw the 5 lines. Here only have to take 3 lines. So this one is A1. This one is A2 for you. And this one is A3 for you. Why are not supposed to go for the 5 lines? Because here we have taken 3:3 from A and 2:2 we have to take from the B. So now on the other hand, we have to not to change this measurement. So what we have measurement we have taken, same measurement, we have to keep on B now, and we have to draw again 2 more lines on the B. 3:2 we have to do now. So we have to keep on B and we have to draw the similar way. So this point now we have the B1. And this point we have the B2. So this is a construction for the line segment. It is in a ratio 3:2. This is not the final answer. This is not the final answer. What is the final answer? Now we have to have the 3:2. So keep on A3 and that B2. Now we have to join. When we will join, it will meet at a point. That point is our C. So now this AC is in a ratio 3 and CB in a ratio 2. So hope this is the final answer. Yes, you got the final answer. You looks like it is an easy method. It looks like a very easy method because first we have to draw an acute angle. Parallel line we have to draw here using the measurement. So next one we have to take here 3 measurement because 3 ratio, and next one is 2 ratio. So here we have to take the 2 ratio and we have to join them. It looks like very easy. Yes, it is looks like a very easy, and answer you are going to get the 6 and 4 because you have taken 10 centimeters. 6, you can see 6 centimeter is a, this side we have 6 centimeter, and on the other hand we have the 4 centimeter. From 6 to 10 means 4 centimeter. Yes, answer is correct, but while constructing the triangle it will be difficult because we can't use this method. So try to use this previous method what we had done here. That method try to understand. This method is also easy when it is line segment is given. So lastly, justification you have tried. This is not the end. So justification is needed. So justification, it carries the marks just for justification. Here you have to write down A to A3. So 3 difference we have taken, divided by B to B2. That is equals to, we have taken how much distance? Same ratio over here. That is nothing but AC divided by CB. Or BC you can write it on. What is that A3 and A to A3? So A to A3, how much units you have taken? 1, 2 and 3. So it is 3. A3 value is 3. Divided by B to B2. B is here, B2 is here. So ratio is how much? 1 and 2. So it is 2. That is equals to AC to CB. They have told the ratio of 3 is to 2 only, no? So here you can see 3 is to 2 only they have asked. And here it is the ratio. AC ratio CB is in the ratio 3:2. That is our answer. So hope you understood this. If you have a doubt, you can ask me in a comment section. Okay.